In this tutorial series, I'm going to show you how to use LumaFusion to edit a video. LumaFusion is touted as the first professional video editing app for the iPhone and iPad. It offers advanced editing options such as multi-track editing and advanced titles. However, it will cost you about $20 in the App Store. In part one of this series, I will introduce you to the LumaFusion workspace and show you how to import media. Once you download the app, open it and turn your device to landscape orientation. Let's start with the LumaFusion workspace. When you open the app, you will see three panels. Upper left is your media library with links to your videos and photos. Upper right is the viewer window where you will review the media. The lower panel is the timeline where you will build your project. Note that you can change the layout of the workspace by tapping the icon to the far right. Then select one of the other options. But I'll stick with the default layout for now. To the left of the layout button is Help and Settings. Under Project Settings, you can alter the frame rate, aspect ratio, and other features. Under Global Settings, you can modify various defaults, such as fitting imported clips and photos. Under Help, you'll find tutorials and guides to using the app. Under Cleanup, you can adjust defaults for handling your files. To see your projects, tap the file icon. To start a project, tap the plus sign, and you are prompted to name your project. You can also adjust the frame rate and aspect ratio. Now let's look at how to import your video footage. In the media panel, you'll see files on your device. The ones I want are in the Moments folder, February 8, 2015. Tapping on that folder opens the clips for that date. Tapping on the clip opens it in the viewer. Tapping the play button lets you review the clip and decide which portion to use.
So here we're at the upper edge of the mangrove forest, and I'll swing around. You can see a few trees picking up, and then back there you can see the extensive stand of mangroves.
After reviewing the clip, I can trim out the section to add to my video project by dragging the handles to bracket the segment I want. You can also use the brackets to set the endpoints for the trimmed clip. Then all we have to do is just tap the down arrow and the clip drops into the timeline. You can use the pinch zoom gesture to reduce or expand the number of frames showing in the timeline. We can continue to trim the clip in the timeline by dragging the ends of the clip. Let's add a second clip. After trimming to the desired section, tap the down arrow. You can also drag a clip from the media library and drop it into the timeline. To undo an action, tap the undo arrow. You can also tap the clip to highlight and tap the trash can. The clip is removed. What if I want to insert the clip not at the end, but between the first two clips? To do this, I position the playhead between those clips and then tap the down arrow. The third clip is inserted between the first two. We can move clips around by dragging the clip to another position in the timeline. As each clip is added to the timeline, you add another part to the story you are building. You'll continue adding clips like this to complete your video. In part two of this tutorial, we'll look at how to modify the audio, add text titles, and make other adjustments.
Bye.